Mini, moving on from your career to your personal life, and like you rightly mentioned that you need support of your friends and family. And I really want to take this moment and, tell this to whoever is watching this, your husband or any other producer. Please, please, and please make a Desi Friends based on your friends group, because all of you guys are so amazing. It is you. It is Shaheen Abbas. I think she's the reverse aging. There is Gaurav Kapoor. There is Sandhya Mridul. There is Cyrus. And I'm forgetting names of people, but yeah, all of you guys are so amazing. I always see these posts of you guys, and every time I see it, and you can make out that it's so real and it's so nice and warm and fun. And every time I see those posts, I'm like, I want to be there. I want to be there in that karaoke. I want to do this. So tell me more about your friends.
My first friends in Bombay were Arshad and Maria, okay? Because Maria was an MTV DJ, and when I didn't know anyone in Bombay, and they sort of just Arshad just he was the first one to come and say, "Hi, I'm Arshad," and welcome, and they just included me in their family immediately, So I have valued their support a lot, and slowly, the kind of friend circle we've kind of, they're all real relationships. They're not based on who's doing what work, who's more popular, who's successful. We've known each other for so many years that we've gotten, in front of each other. We've kind of lived our lives. We've had babies. We've grown them up. Those babies are now applying to college. I think we've shared real lives with each other, and therefore there's real respect. And all of us are self-made people. I don't think anyone was offered anything on a platter.
Platter,
We all
exactly.
came, we found our feet, we helped each other. When one was low, we've always been there. And yes, arguably I should be friends with A-list Bollywood, but we all find comfort and solace with, your friends who've been there for you when you started, right? So yeah, we're all looking forward to growing old together, yeah.
Touch wood. I really hope that happens. That is amazing because I would love to continue watching you guys together.
We all a mad bunch also. I mean, it's all people, they're all mad
Exactly
people,
what I'm saying. It's very real. I
and
can tell.
we are from a generation of MTV where we genuinely cared for each other. It wasn't, we weren't perfect, even though we were all DJs on the same, Gaurav was not on the same channel, he was on Channel B, but we have had such genuine affection for each other, even when we were working, that working became fun. It wasn't a competitive, cutthroat atmosphere where we wanted their each other's shows, or we wanted to better the person. We all just wanted to come work and get the hell out of, the studios and hang with each other. And I think that sense of acceptance and love has withstood so many years. I mean, I first met Cyrus when he was 17 years old. So,
Cyrus Sankar.
it's been Cyrus Sankar and I took the same flight to Bombay for the first time.
Wow.
So, yeah, we've kind of lived a great life.
Wow. And then how did you meet Kabir and what made you think that yehi mere sapno ka Rajkumar hai?
सपनों का राजकुमार, एटलीस्ट एट दैट पॉइंट तो वही लगा था. बट आई मेट कबीर इन दिल्ली. आई थिंक वी वर ऑन अ शूट. आई मीन देयर वाज अ शूट दैट ही वाज सपोज्ड टू डू. ही वाज अ फ्रीलांस सिनेमाटोग्राफर एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम, एंड आई वाज अ टीवी होस्ट. आई रिमेम्बर वी वर बोथ ऑफर्ड द सेम शो, हिम टू शूट ऑफ कोर्स एंड मी टू होस्ट, एंड वी डिडंट हैव टाइम फॉर इट. एंड वी मेट एट द प्रोड्यूसर्स ऑफिस टू टेल देम दैट वी डोंट हैव टाइम. बट वी मेट ईच अदर एंड वी गॉट टॉकिंग, एंड वी सडनली decided to make time and shoot the show. And for me,
Wow.
it was just, I've been such a good girl because my parents had let me do, what I wanted to do in my career, that I did not want to let them down. It was like शाहरुख इन डीडीएलजे, पेरेंट्स को गुस्सा करके कुछ नहीं करना है. So I have, but I when I met Kabir, I just knew. It was just one of those things when they say, the bell rang and the earth moved and all of that. I think both of us knew that this is it. This is it. And we married very early, and we were very sure that we wanted to. At that point, I hadn't even moved to Bombay. Like I said, he was just making documentaries in Delhi. And we didn't know where life was going to take us, but...
And were your parents supportive about it, or was there typical drama, kaise ye wo?
Well, it's funny because, you know, it is, of course, it was an interfaith marriage. Right. And at that point, there wasn't any of the dirty, you know, Islamophobia that you see in the country today, or the kind of communalism. It was still, of course, Mathurs marrying anybody outside Mathurs was always a big deal, whether it's, you know, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, doesn't matter. Mathuron se bahar shaadi nahi honi chahiye.
Right.
So for me, that was more the scary part, that it's a non-Mathur, not that it's a non-Hindu. You know, that was not a big deal. So, but I think once my parents just met Kabir, and I didn't say that I want to marry him. I used to have a lot of friends coming in, going out, and my father and he developed a really good relationship. And then my father asked me, why aren't you considering him? I was like, no, he's Muslim. So they were like, "So kya ho gya? Khan aur Khanna mein sirf NA ka farak hota hai."
So
I think eventually they understood that it's important to marry the right person, not the right faith or the right surname or the right, you know. Wow. So I didn't have any of those issues, and I must say that I've, touch wood, but I've never had to answer for any of that.
Right. Wow. That's amazing. So very recently, I was interviewing this radio jockey from Dubai, and you know, when we were having this conversation, she mentioned that when she was going through her low, she was like, she was pregnant and she was in the mall with bags, and log dekhenge unko, but no one will come up and offer help to her, that, you know, we'll carry some bags for you or whatever. So she decided at that point that she wanted to raise her kids to be kind people, right? And that's her definition of success. So what is it that you have thought that, you know, this is what I'm going to imbibe in my kids?
I think first, before anything else, I want them to have respect and compassion. And respect is one of the most important things. So my kids, you will never, you know, you meet kids nowadays, they don't even look into your eyes when they're saying hello.
Right.
They're like, hello. I was like, you have to make eye contact. You have to genuinely show that you you respect that person. So my kids are very people. Okay, they genuinely love family. They have a lot of value on family time, on grandparents, on cousins, and friends. And I must say that they are good kids. They are respectful kids, and I want them to know that, you know, being human is more important than being anything else. So compassion for not just the environment and animals, it's towards compassion towards every place, anywhere in the country. So I have traveled with them extensively after Corona. Ever since they were like a few weeks old, I have traveled with my children. I've taught them wonderful things about the world and life during travels, about how to handle crisis, about how to look at people, how to be experimental with food, how to not be stranger-phobic. You know, we are mostly raising our kids to be stranger-phobic, which means, unse baat mat karo, wo tumhe utha ke le jayenge. Wo wale uncle gande hai, unhe haath mat lagane dena. Ye wali aunty se door rehen. I have made, let them make up their own mind. Of course, you keep an eye on everything and you tell them about good touch, bad touch and all of that. But eventually, they have to make up their own minds about people with the vibe they get from them. You know, I can only tell them to be careful, but I don't make them phobic of people. You know, I don't want to take them through life telling them people are inherently bad. I want them to think people are inherently good. And you have to go with that thought. Till somebody disappoints you, you have to assume that they are good people. And I think they're going somewhere with that.
That whole phase, like, I used to watch Indian Idol to be able to see you, and I would you know, vote for the contestants, not because I loved them, but because Mini Mathur has said that please vote kijiye. So I was small and I would take my papa's phone and I would kind of vote, and I'll tell you who I voted for. I voted for Abhijit Sawant and he won also, so I was like so happy. But yeah, like, I would, the primary reason I would watch Indian Idol was to see you. I would be like, wow, मिनी माथुराज क्या पहनेगी, शी यू नो यू आर माय आई कैंडी. सो एंड आई रिमेंबर दैट वेरी रिसेंटली यू पोस्टेड दिस पिक्चर एंड आई ड्रॉप्ड अ कमेंट ऑन दैट पिक्चर, आई विल पुट इट समवेयर हियर ऑन द स्क्रीन, दैट यू सो प्रीटी, आई ऑलवेज ट्राई टू बी लाइक यू, आई ट्राई एंड आई फेल.
आई सॉरी, योर क्वेश्चन.
नो, प्लीज प्लीज टेल मी. I'll get to
So you wanted me to tell you about Indian Idol, right?
Yes. And after that, I'll ask you something.
No, I mean, so for me, it was a show that literally ended up defining my career.
Exactly.
Nobody had any idea about how popular it would become. Of course, we knew it was a very popular international format, but nobody was ready for the kind of wave of love that would, you know. And I remember I was right out of MTV and Sony was like, देखो ज्यादा MTV मत झाड़ना यहाँ पर, यू नो इट्स अ जनरल एंटरटेनमेंट शो, बट फॉर मी इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू लीव माय ओन पर्सनालिटी ऑन अ शो, यू नो, इफ आई कैन बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय समबडी एल्स सो इजीली देन व्हाई एम आई देयर, यू नो. सो स्लोली एंड स्लोली दे रियलाइज दैट, यू नो, व्हाटएवर लिटिल आई पुट इनटू द शो, पीपल वर एंजॉयिंग कनेक्टिंग विद मी, एंड लाइक आई सेड, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू टॉक विद पीपल, नॉट टू टॉक at them, you know, you don't, you're exactly. not lecturing them, you're connecting with them, and that's very important. And I think jokes aside, I think it took the country, you know, the country's imagination, because everybody felt like I was their cousin or something, you know,
exactly.
like this is our part of, you know, the whole game. And I remember the popularity was huge, that we used to shoot for the result episodes live, literally a few hours before it was telecast, and we used to shoot through the night, and in the morning, I wasn't allowed to go to sleep till I posted the name of the person who went out on the door, because wow. so many people would call my mom-in-law in the morning and say, ask her who went out before the episode was telecast. Hey. So the show got a lot of love, and yes, my look and my outfits did get a lot of attention, but that's also because I decided to keep it simple, you know, I mean, I was like, I don't want to do the 1990s ka filmy hangover ke outfits, you know, let me just wear a simple sari, you know.
Exactly.
And everyone was like, sari, why would you want to wear a sari? I said, because it looks great and I love saris, and you know, so I decided to wear my favorite raw mango saris, and it just found so much resonance with everyone that I was allowed to kind of decide what I wanted to wear, whether it was just a simple salwar kameez with a dupatta or a pants or whatever. They left it up to me.
Right.
And I'm so happy to know that everyone
was
just watching.
What Indian Idol did for you essentially was they took you out of that MTV indie pop culture, and then from not just me and my sister knowing you, it also you became a part of our home, like where my parents also know you.
Which was very important to me, very important.
Exactly. Yeah. And I think you did that. The other thing popular about Indian Idol, apart from your outfits, were their auditions. Like, I still, to date, go to YouTube and search for that Aashiq Banaya, Aapne Wala clip, for example. You know, so they were like genuinely, you know, these people who may or may not have been great singers, but they genuinely thought that they are good and they would come to audition. And I've always noticed ki unka, you know, mazak udaya jayega and all of that. But the one thing that I've noticed about you, and which is why I was grinning from year to year when you were talking about your kids, that, you know, respect is important, because I've noticed this in you also, that aapne kabhi nahi kiya, you have never, you know, disgraced them, disrespected them, made fun of them. You are always very poised, very graceful, and, you know, very encouraging towards them. So there's this grace, there's this respect that I see.
I don't think it was pretense, and I speak for Hussain also, because he's also an extremely respectful human being who would not hurt anyone just to get some, you know, TRPs or extra laughs.
Exactly.
And I think both of us worked well together because we shared the same ethos and we shared the same feelings, because we were there. We realized what being on the show meant to all these people.
Right.
We knew what kind of dreams they were bringing and how poor they were and what it took for them to come to the auditions, stand in lines for hours and hours. And, this really meant a big deal. And who were we to sit and mock them? You know, yes, the show's format is such that we would club you know, terrible singers in one edit and say, okay, these didn't make it. Huh. But it's not my job to show you down. I mean, right. I still respect the fact that you had enough guts to come and do your thing. I mean, you know, I'm not the judge in junior.
Yeah. You did a great job. Thank you for it. Another thing that I wanted to talk to you about is that, see, I have a very strong personality, right? And you also have a very strong personality. But the thing about you is that you're also equally feminine. Like, so how do you do that?
I don't think I am. I think I'm quite a, you know, pehlwan in real life. And I asked, tell that.
I didn't want to say this about myself. Like, I am this patan.
They will not agree with you at all. They think I'm a fire-breathing dragon. Very honestly, most of the time, I have to play bad cop. So, I'm not the nicest person to know. But, I mean, thank you. I'll just take that as a compliment. I think we need to stop setting standards for what is feminine and what is not feminine. I think personality by far supersedes look, and you know, you have to be who you are. Why would you change that for anything? Then you just be part of the crop.
Amazing. I love that. Okay, so coming to it, you always look the bomb.com. How do you do that?
Sorry?
You always look like you're the bomb.com. How do you do that?
Bomb.com to koi nahi hai.
Aap hi ho.
Bomb.com to nahi hai. Don't believe what you see on Insta. Insta has always the best angles. You know, you always give your right when you the light is beautiful and the hair is looking perfect.
Yeah, you can't miss good hair.
You put that on Insta. So half the people who believe
Let me pause you right there. Because if I wear a hairband right now, I'm having a good hair day. This is my blow-dried hair. And if I wear a hairband right now, even then I'll look homeless. But aap hairband mein bhi achhe lagte ho. Like, for real.
Thank you. I think that's just kind eyes. I don't feel beautiful 23 out of 24 hours in the day. And nobody can. It's unreal to set those kind of standards for yourself also. But bomb.com, meko naam achha laga, ye main rakhungi. When I'm feeling low, I will just think about this.
Done. So I can also keep the episode name as bomb.com on the show.
Perfect.
So Mini, please share some styling and dressing up tips ताकि हमारी तरह जो plain jeans हो वो भी आपकी तरह thebomb.com लग पाए.
एक तो आप ये कहना बंद करें कि आप plain jeans हैं. Okay, plain jeans तो कोई होता नहीं. You must understand that everyone you see on a red carpet or in a television show or on the show is being styled by a lot of people.
Right.
उनका makeup हो रहा है, उनके बाल बन रहे हैं, तब जाके वो वैसे लगते हैं जैसे आपको दिखता है. घर पे आप उनको देखेंगे तो आप भी घबरा जाएंगे और प्लेन जीन सब लगते हैं घर पे. सो आई डोंट थिंक ऑफ दैट, बट यस आई डू थिंक इट्स क्वाइट इम्पोर्टेंट टू कीप योरसेल्फ ग्रूम. यू शुड नेवर लेट योरसेल्फ गो हाउएवर ओल्ड यू आर और हाउएवर इफ यू गिवन बर्थ टू किड्स. इट्स इम्पोर्टेंट टू बी फिट. इट्स इम्पोर्टेंट टू कीप योर बॉडी इन अ सर्टेन शेप, नॉट बिकॉज यू वांट टू फिट इनटू अ साइज, बट बिकॉज एवरीथिंग लुक्स गुड ऑन यू इफ यू आर फिट. नाउ आई एम अ फूडी. So I eat indiscriminately, but that's the only reason, and that's one thing I've sort of learned from my husband, who's quite, you know, he's quite the fitness freak, and he's the one who constantly eggs me on to continue the whole, even when I feel like giving up and saying, now I don't give a shit, and he's like, no, you have to work out. And I think fitness is very important. So once, I remember John Abraham saying that if you've got a good body, even a sack, gunny sack will look good on you. Gunny white t-shirt or jeans pehno to bhi acche lagoge. So, you know, it's a question of maintaining that fitness level, and that, and if you're fit, then you'll eventually have a good body. In terms of styling, again, I find styling is very personal. It's very distinctive. You must wear what you enjoy. I've never sort of followed trends because somebody is wearing it on the international red carpet. I mean, those big, big gowns, I feel very alien. I mean, even though I had to wear them as part of my work a lot of times, and I've enjoyed wearing some of them. At some point, I felt, okay, this is ridiculous. Okay, why am I looking like Cinderella? Why should I be going to a Indian awards function with a Western Met Gala gown? Why? I would rather wear a sari, which is something I feel makes Indian women look very beautiful, and it just shows up your body, and it's got different ways to wrap itself. I love it. I love the garment, and I'm a big propounder of sarees. My wardrobe has the most beautiful colors on the planet in it. So I invest a lot in sari.
Right.
I invest a lot in classic clothing, which is white and black and blue, and very structured, tailored pants and shirts, because I think that looks very nice. I don't think showing your body in the most obvious way is the fun way to do it. I think it's nicer to wear a sari and, you know, have a little bit of this and a little bit of that. And I think that's far more namkeen than anything else.
I love that. All right. So Mini, I've reached a point in my life where I have a life funda and I've kind of flow charted it. It's very simple. That does it make you happy? Yes, do it. Does not make you happy? Don't do it. So what is your life funda?
I think it's go with the flow. I think every time I have tried to swim against the current, it's been very disturbing. I'd like to go with the flow of everything, but make things around me work for me at that point, you know. So, and yes, one of the things which is important in the go with the flow thing is don't do anything that doesn't seem right or doesn't feel good. Because if it doesn't feel good, it's like people try to conquer their fears and say, I want to do skydiving because I'm so scared of it and I want to conquer my fear. I want to conquer no fears. Because there's obviously something in my body telling me, don't do it. I won't do it.
Right.
I don't want to be
Khatron ki khiladan.
Action star Khatron ki khiladi. For what reason? You know, I don't like it. I don't want to do it. I won't do it. You can't make me, you know. And I'm not lesser for it, you know, because I didn't do that skydive. You know, I do fairly adventurous things. I do scuba diving and, you know, we do all kinds of crazy things when we travel. But I don't want to skydive. So, the point is that you have to do what makes you feel positive, which makes your gut say, yeah, this is okay, I'll do it. Rely on that judgment. And just keep working at it and, you know, keep making things around you positive. So even if you are in a jhopri for the next 2 months, make that jhopri pretty, yeah.
Exactly.
You know, just make that wonderful. Like my kids often ask me, you know, what is it that you will be happy if you become? I was like, you become the best at what you do. It doesn't matter if you're making clay pots, but you be the best bloody clay potter the world has seen.
Wow.
That's all. It doesn't matter what you're learning and whether you will find a cure for cancer or whether you change the world. Just do whatever you are planning to do and be the best at it.
Wow. I love that. So I told you, I give you the context of where I come from and why I started Behenko, right? So that it's very important for me to kind of create this content for that one Filoni who's upset somewhere and she's thinking very low of herself. And this piece helps her feel better, right? So women empowerment is my mission, right? And I will do whatever it takes to empower women, right? So, same way, what is it that you are really passionate about?
It would be, good living, I suppose. You know, holistic, not in the term that it's used now, okay, organic. I feel balance is very important for everyone.
Right.
And there is a right time and a right place to do what you should be doing in life, and you must give yourself those moments to live those little pockets of life. So if it is that you have to take 6 months off to do what you're doing, you have to do it. Let everything else adjust to it. If you want to have a baby when you're at the peak of your career, like I did, I need to do it. I will do it. Everything else will fall around it. So I think balance is really important, and I'm passionate about finding that balance and helping people to find that positivity from that balance.
Wow.
So yes, like you, I also feel very, like you asking me about my group of friends and why we are so connected. That's because it's nice to empower other women to feel good about themselves, because I think women per se are the last ones to get any adulation or any gratitude or any sort of compliments for the invisible work that they do
exactly
in their daily life. So, you know, I mean, a regular woman would get up in the morning, she'll have a bath, she'll cook all the meals, she'll pack her tiffins, she'll put her kids ready, she'll make her kids ready to go to school, she'll put them in the bus, she'll wear a sari, she'll go take a bus and she'll go to a bank and she'll work and then she'll come back. And husband comes back and he'll watch TV and maybe the, you know, the sweet ones will have, but she will get into the kitchen and she'll have homework and she'll cook and she'll do this.
Exactly.
It's tough. And at that point, I'm saying maybe women can multitask. Maybe they're better at handling so many things. Maybe they're just better as a species. But do they get enough appreciation to feel good about themselves? Maybe not. So if other women can do it, instead of waiting for the spouses or the boyfriends or the to come and make them feel better, why not? So I think it's high time that, and it's good that you're also empowering women to feel the positivity and to live better lives and to just get those endorphins going. You know, it's important for them, everybody, to have a system.
Wow. So many, we've seen you on Mind the Malhotras last, right? Where do we see you next?
Whoa. So, right now, I don't know if anybody's seeing anyone again with the COVID situation.
Right.
But let's hopefully once it clears off, I have season two of this show I do on Discovery called Discovery School Super Kids, which is India's biggest sort of school quiz. It has 55,000 schools participating. There is season two of Malhotras, hopefully, around the corner.
I can't wait.
There is season two of my show called Mini-Me, which is my travel show.
Yes.
Of, you know, the mom and daughter, which is all ready. And as soon as I can put it on a platform, I will. So, and I'm hoping to revive a show called Mini Truck, where I used to cook with film stars. I don't know if you've seen that.
No, but I will.
We only shot four episodes of the Mini Truck. It's on YouTube, so you can watch it. And I, as soon as COVID allows us to, I'm going to revive that show as well.
You absolutely should. I remember watching your stories. Ek din apne you cooked up this meze platter, and you mentioned that you were just cleaning your cabinets or fridge, and you know, you found these sauces and ingredients that were about to expire, and you're like, yeah, before that happens, let me just do that. And I'm like, agar mujhe mila hota na aisa kuch expire hone wala, main to nahi bolti socials pe ke aise hai, but ye, she's so real, to tumhe kyun sharam aa rahi hai?
You have to be real, you know. People, yeah. I think, can detect whether you're being real or you're being fake, and
yeah,
it's important. If somebody is taking the trouble to follow you and comment on your post, I think you deserve to give them some truths.
Right. Wow. And finally, what is that one thing that you would want to tell my audience?
Well, I think I have said more than enough for three interviews, but I will still say that you have to, you know, find your space, find what it is that gives you happiness and go for it, because I think life is too short and the world can change its colors any moment. And I think if there's something you haven't said to someone or something that you always wanted to do, don't wait up, you know, just do it.
Done.
That's all.
I love
maybe
that.
Maybe Nike will have to pay me for this because I said just do it.
I will try and reach out to the Nike guy also and I'll make sure they make you the Indian brand ambassador.
Thank you, Pilani.
Thank you so
such
much.
A nice chat.
No,
I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
I wish you all the best. You're a very easy interviewer. You have a very good energy about you when you're, and I'm giving this as feedback from somebody who's done this for a while, and I know that you're taking 6 months off to do this. It's very important to have good energy if you're going to be talking to people,
yeah,
and also listen and be spontaneous and form the flow of a conversation basis what they've said rather than have a fixed set of questions and go back to it and spoil the organic flow of the conversation. So props where you deserve it. I think you make it big.
Thank you. I love you. Thank you so much for being on the show.
You're welcome.
This is so fun.
Thank you for having me.
They said, don't fall. forget all the things you've been taught, you've been told. Don't blink, don't run, don't turn left or turn right or look straight at the sun. My mind's gone in circles, I'm trying to fight it, getting these voices inside to stay quiet. Gone to the place.